Hey friends, welcome back. In this video tutorial series of DevOps, I shall be talking about Docker, another important tool used in DevOps methodology. In the previous video, I talked about Kubernetes, the link of which has been given in the description below. Let us look at the agenda of today's session. We shall discuss about the need of using a Docker. What is Docker and its working mechanism? Different components of Docker. Difference between virtual machines and Docker. Then we'll move on and see the use case on Docker. And finally, hands-on exercise to create a Docker image. So let's begin. Why do we need Docker? When a software developer builds an application, it works fine with his computer and environment. But when the same piece of software is shared with another team, like operations or testing team, they'll face some issues with the application. And this is the most common problem that occurs in the application industries. This problem occurs mainly because of the difference in the computing environment. So, how this can be resolved? Before we get into the core topic, let us first understand what is microservices. Microservice architecture is all about breaking down a large service into various small or microservices. For example, in an organization, we will have different teams, namely HR team, finance team, operations teams, sales team, project management team, etc. And these small teams work together to form an organization. And these teams can be termed as microservices of that particular organization. Let us say we have got 5 microservices in an operations, which requires a host machine, and all these 5 microservices require 5 virtual machines, which includes dependencies of that microservice. The resources are not completely used by the microservices in virtual machines. And this problem with virtual machines is a waste of resources. And this resource can be RAM, disk, or processors. And this is something when you have got just 5 microprocessors. Now think, if you have to deal with hundreds of microprocessors and hence the amount of unused space. This was the main problem with virtual machines. So what you think? How this can be resolved? This is certainly resolved by using Docker. So Docker is a tool that is used to create, deploy, and run applications using Docker containers. These containers are used as alternatives to virtual machines and are of lightweight. As you can see, Docker uses host operating system, and Docker engine is placed on the host operating system. Docker containers are formed with the help of Docker engine, which includes applications and its dependencies in it. Docker engine can have multiple containers on it. Let us see in detail how it works. A developer will develop an application which includes coding and the application requirements. And these are stored in a Docker file. Docker images are created using these Docker files. And this includes the applications and dependencies of that application. You can also see Docker containers in the image. These Docker containers are nothing but runtime instances of the Docker image. This Docker image will be uploaded into Docker Hub. And Docker Hub acts as a repository for Docker images, which includes public and private repositories. With the help of the Docker Hub, the different teams or operations download the Docker image to create their own Docker containers based on their requirement. This resolves the issue of dependencies and differences in the computing environment, which we stated in our problem statement. So in this way, the Docker delivers an entire package of applications and dependencies throughout the lifecycle of the application. Now let us move on to Docker components. Docker registry. It is a storage of Docker images. These images can be either private or public repositories. Docker images. These are the read-only templates used to create Docker containers. It contains applications and its dependencies. You can also create your own image and upload it on Docker Hub. Docker containers. Docker containers are the runtime instances of Docker images. It can be built using one or more Docker images. Docker Compose. Let us say we have multiple applications on various containers and they are linked to each other. So you don't want to execute these containers one by one and run all at once with one command. So in this case, you can use Docker Compose, which runs multiple applications with one single command. Docker Daemon. Docker Daemon creates and manages Docker objects such as Docker image, Docker containers. Docker Daemon runs on the host machine. Now let us see the difference between virtual machines and Docker containers. Virtual machines and Docker containers mainly differ in three features, namely size, startup, and integration. Let us see in detail one by one. When compared to size, you can consider virtual machine as a hippo and Docker container as a cat. For better understanding, let us consider an example. When you have 14 GB of RAM and you have to run three virtual machines of 5 GB, 5 GB and 4 GB each. Say your first virtual machine uses 2 GB, second 3 GB and third virtual machine uses 2 GB of RAM. So the total amount of RAM used will be of 7 GB and we are wasting another 7 GB of RAM which cannot be reused. However, in the case of Docker, CPU will allocate only the required amount of the data that is used for each Docker container. Like the first application will be allocated 2 GB of RAM, second will have 3 GB and third will have 2 GB of RAM accordingly. And the total amount of space used will be only 7 GB and you are still left with 7 GB of free RAM. So virtual machines takes a lot of time to start up, whereas Docker can start up in a few seconds. You can compare virtual machines and Dockers as a cart and jet respectively. This is because virtual machine first have to boot up the host operating system, hypervisors, and in turn set up different virtual machines. This is because virtual machine first have to boot up the host operating system, hypervisors, and in turn set up different virtual machines. This is time consuming. In case of a Docker, boot time is not required as the Docker containers will be running on your host operating system. Integration in virtual machine is possible, however, it is not a cost effective and makes a complex task, whereas Docker is faster, cheap, and easily scalable. And hence, apparently, Docker containers are more advantageous in comparison with the virtual machines. Did you know? BBC News that delivers broadcast and online news in almost 30 languages, over 80,000 news items in English alone, uses Docker. Before the adoption of Docker, BBC used to face problem largely on speed and volume. It ran more than 26,000 jobs in 10 different continuous integration environments with sequential scheduling, resulting in a chronic logjam and a combined wait and runtime of up to 60 minutes per job. The problem was resolved by Docker, which allowed BBC News to eliminate job wait times. It also gave developers a flexible continuous integration environment that is easy to work with and which allows much greater control over factors as application architecture. Let us now talk about the companies using Docker. According to the Datadog report, the move to Docker is actually being led by larger companies rather than smaller companies. Docker's spotlight partners are Microsoft, HP Enterprises, and Alibaba Cloud. Some of the other companies are Accenture, Evernade, Cognizant, CSC, CSRA, and Leaders. Now let us see how to create a Docker environment image. So we can check whether any image or Docker container is running or not using the command ps. So nothing is running, so let's revisit. Now how to build a Docker image and how to launch it. Let us see that. So first you need to build a certain folder called Docker codebase, or you name it anything you want just to keep it organized. Then we also have a container which has a web server. So for that, I have created two files. First one is Docker file, and the second one is a script. So this Docker file, where we would be telling what this container should have and what all packages should we be installing in it. And the second one is the script, which launches the services inside the container. So these two would allow us to create a container. Now let us go back to the Docker file. So what are the various syntax? Let us see that. The most basic syntax which you must begin with is from, okay? The first line. So this from would tell you which images to use for this container. We are using CentOS 7 image. So it will pull it from Docker Hub and build it, okay? Then we have got maintainer in the second line. This is nothing but a command. Even label is a command of what are the versions. But these are optional. Even if you don't put these two lines, it will work. But it's a good practice to put at least maintainer. Label is not needed. Okay? So you can avoid it. Then there is run, which would run the command when you build the image. It will run the command inside the image and get the image built. Like what we are telling it, you take CentOS and run this command inside it. What happens when we run the yum command? It installs Apache server as we need this Apache server here. Okay, so install yum install minus y and this. So this will install the Apache over here. Then this syntax. What does it do? This expose 80. This exposes our open support inside the Docker image. Why are we exposing this 80 code? Because httpd and Apache listens to 80 code. That's why we wrote this. Then we have got this add. So when you have to add a certain file inside the container, you use this syntax add. And where do you want to add the file? You have to provide the path for that. So inside the Docker container, I'm keeping this file under slash. So this directly goes to the root of the Docker. And then we have got the executable permission to this file so that the script can execute. Now CMD. So CMD stands for the command which will run inside the container once the container is running, not when it is being built. Because when we build it, we want just the Apache to be there. We don't want it to run. We want it to run when the system is running, like when the Docker container is running. Okay? So we keep a shell script to start Apache. So now you must be thinking, how do I know what things to be done and where? So we all use template files from Docker Hub and modified. So in that template, whatever is there for CentOS 7 version, we can use it. And you can see in CentOS 7, like the computer is, you know, CentOS 7. So if you go to init.d, you won't find Apache. Only networking is there. See, only network is there. So according to the distribution, you can find out. That's why I'm saying what do we do is we go to Docker Hub and find the images. Let's say I need Apache for, let me just go to Docker Hub. So I need Apache for Apache CentOS 7 Docker. Okay. So there are two places to look for. One is the github.com. Else you can go to the Docker Hub. So someone has done it and Docker Hub itself has officially made this. So who is providing all these official images? The project itself, like CentOS itself is providing. They want people to use CentOS in Docker, so they provide it. See the Apache image they are providing. So I can go and see their Docker files. You can get to any version if they have shared that. You can see the Docker files. Here they do not have shared Docker file. Doesn't matter. You can directly pull it and it will start working. But if someone has got or has not shared Docker file, you can find its repo info from GitHub. Okay. So say you want to go to the GitHub. So mostly some owners are liberals. They will share the Docker file here. So you can directly see those. Okay. Now let's try and build one image. Okay. So the build syntax would be very simple, which is Docker build hyphen d. So that's what I'm going to type in here. The command, which is Docker build hyphen t. Okay. So t is for tagging. Whatever image you want to build, you can tag it with a certain name, just like these persons have named their image according to the different tags. CentOS Apache, this is their, you know, repository name. So you can rename your shell, your repository. So let's say your repository or project name is DevOps group. That's what I'm going to give it, the name. Okay, DevOps group. So say this is your project name. Then we can give the image. So this is a good practice, like giving project name or repository name, and then you give your image name like CentOS Apache. Okay, so let us do that. CentOS Apache is our image name. So this was the image. And then you can also give a version. Now this is optional. Even if you do not give anything, so it takes latest as the tag. So if I don't give any version, it will automatically pick this one, the latest one. But say if I have a semantic versioning system, just like 1.0.1, or just like other softwares, software have. So let me simply give it 1.0. So let's say if I make it 1.0 and I have put a dot after that. Dot means these two files will be used present in this current location to build the image. So now this image is built successfully, and we have got our image built successfully using this Docker. Okay, so I hope you guys got a clear idea of how to build an image in this Docker. Now let us move forward and summarize what we discussed in today's session. So we started with the problem statement and how Docker helps in resolving that problem. Then we discussed different components of Docker and its working mechanism. We also discussed the difference between virtual machines and Docker containers. Then we saw how BBC is using Docker to eliminate their job wait times and how to create Docker images. Intellipaat offers DevOps certification course designed with the help of leading industry professionals to help you learn the key skills of DevOps tools, which includes Docker and many other tools. I hope this video was informative for you. For any inquiries, feel free to contact us. In the subsequent videos, we shall be discussing some other important tool used in DevOps methodology. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.